in the escape room, and they soon find... Oh, why hello there again. So, welcome back to Halloween in January 5. And we are on day 16, the halfway point of this series. Yeah, the final halfway point of this final series. So, let's carry on with our horror reviews, as this is Halloween in January, where we take the month of October and put it in January for one last time as well. So today, I am reviewing the film Escape Room, directed by Adam Robitel, and starring Taylor Russell, Logan Miller, Deborah Ann Wall, True Blood, Tyler Labine, Nick Dodine, Jay Ellis, Yorick Wan Wagenin or something. So this is a psychological horror film where some strangers are, you know, meet in this building that does escape rooms with a money reward of 10,000 American dollars if they should succeed in the escape room. And they soon find that this is no ordinary escape room. They go through a series of rooms and soon discover that these clues in the rooms are all playing on their minds. And we soon discover that it's all death traps and they're all getting picked off one by one. We soon find out that the whole games, every year they do different themes of people, like athletic people, and then the year that this one came out, soul survivors, as they all have survived an incident. They soon find that there is no reward. They're all dying and getting picked off one by one. So let's get on to my likes and dislikes about this one. First of all, the likes. I like this film. Is there any originality in there? Yes, as I don't recall a film where there has been an escape room. Oh wait, there's a 2017 escape room that's an indie film that's not as well known. You know, it's on Netflix, but I watched it and I thought it was a bit boring and crap. But this one was way more entertaining. I also liked our cast in this, including one of them, Deborah Ann Wall, who I know as Jessica from True Blood, and Karen Page in Daredevil. I thought she did a great performance in this as a war veteran, but unfortunately her character did not make it, which I thought was a shame. I was like, oh, I liked her. I also liked the rooms that they went into. They were first in a room where they were waiting for the games master, but then they soon discover that they are in the escape room, and they got to get out before the whole room turns into an oven and cooks them alive. They find then that they're in another room that's a cabin, and then it's an icy landscape, and they got to melt a key out of some ice to get into the next room, which is an upside down bar, and they go on to go to more deadlier rooms. Yeah, I like that. I like that there was, you know, that they were, it was kind of like Saw. Yes, that's what everyone refers to when they see this film, I think. Everyone, I think, thought of the film Saw, which I also thought of as well. It was like Saw. Oh, these weren't people that have done wrong in life or don't value life. These are people that are survivors. I also liked the suspense in this. I forget, are they going to get out of this? Are they going to survive? And of course, two do survive. We get a final guy and a final girl in this. And they're both probably the smartest out of them all. Well, this film opens where we see one of them in the escape room, and it's one of those movies where they cut straight to the chase, but then they go back hours or days earlier before the event. That's a bit overplayed now, isn't it? But still, I thought that was, yeah, alright, you know, letting us know what we're kind of getting ourselves in for. And yeah, I liked the smart decision that our final girl made in this, with the final guy, how they fought their way through and actually beat these people. Turns out these were all people that were crazed rich people that were bidding to see who would survive, like in Hostel or something like that, but they weren't tortured medievally, they were just going through a series of terrible traps and games. So, my dislikes. I don't know what to dislike about this film. As I said, it was pretty fast paced. There was a little bit of a slow build around the beginning part, but within less than half an hour the film got rolling, and I enjoyed that. I like films that get straight to it, that don't spend a good portion of the film being a slow burner. So yeah, I like this. I also like there was a bit of action in this, and I also like the ending. I mean, the ending did kind of tease at a sequel, which we are getting this year in 2020. You know, Escape Room 2. I don't know when that's out, but I shall be going to see it when it's out with Dr. Freako, my new master. Shame my master isn't here to see the new one come out, but we did see this one together before he started to get really ill. Okay, so my ratings for this one. Escape Room was an entertaining film. Interesting, like, traps and kills in there. So with all that being said, I'm going to give Escape Room, you know what, I will give it a 3.5 scalpels out of 5. 3.5 scalpels out of 5 for Escape Room. So, that has been my review on Escape Room. This has been Halloween in January 5, day 16, the halfway point. So, we're halfway into this series. We've gone through 15 days already. We have another 15 before our final ever episode. So, be sure to tune in for all those that are to come. You can even watch the series so far, so let me know what you think to this one down below in the comments. If you like this video, be sure to give it a big thumbs up. Don't forget to share with your friends. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel if you haven't already, the Random Horror YouTube channel, and to hit the notification bell to stay notified and to share with your friends. All of the social media links are down below in the description. So, I have been your host, Frank N. Stein, and until tomorrow, don't have nightmares.